Well, if the burning flag in Egypt didn't stop us from handing them billions, maybe this will.
طبعا حضرتك يمكن انا من هواة المعارك وحب المعارك جدا مع الاعداء طبعا مع امريكا واسرائيل لكن هذه المعركه لابد ان تخاض بمنتهى الحكمه والهدوء والسكون.
With the enemies, America and Israel, we're the enemy. This is one of Egypt's leading politicians who thought his comments would never be heard, calling America and Israel the enemy. The same America, by the way, that just gave an additional $1.3 billion in military aid. The same America that we're told from this government, we're friend, to Colonel West, who says, no, no, no. These are not friends. Colonel, what do you make of this?
Well, you're absolutely right. These are not friends. The Muslim Brotherhood clearly has stated that we are our enemies. We are their enemies, and as a matter of fact, back in 1991, when the document was uncovered in a raid here in Northern Virginia by the FBI, it was the explanatory memorandum for the Grand Jihad that the Muslim Brotherhood intended for America and also North America. And even here on our own shores, we have these front groups, such as the Council for American Islamic Relations, the Islamic Society of North America, the Muslim Student Association, the Muslim Political Action Committee, are all implementing their goal and their design. So here we are, you know, subjugating ourselves and sending $1.3 billion of taxpayer money without congressional approval, may I add, from this administration to the people that sees us as their enemies.
You know what's interesting when you listen to that tape a little bit, and I didn't listen to it as much as my producers did, but there's hardly condemnation from the crowd in there, like, oh, no, stop it, don't say that. But, well, you know, they're nodding their head, they're listening. There's nothing outrageous being said. Normally, if you hear an outrageous or asinine comment, people just say, what? None of that. So methinks that others in that room and around that table and dais agree, and I'm thinking, we're giving these guys money hand over fist. Stop.
Yeah, that was a special cabinet meeting of President Morsi. And even after they were told that they were on live Egyptian television, they just kind of laughed it off. And the gentleman that made that statement, he didn't retract it whatsoever. So this is a true window into who this our quote-unquote ally, Egypt, is. They see us as an enemy, and they were even
talking
about...
Then why do we keep giving good money after bad, Colonel? I mean, it's one thing to try to put a deposit down on friendship, but I'll be damned if I'm going to buy anyone's hatred. What's going on here?
Well, if you want the short southern answer, because we have an administration that is absolutely stupid. There is no reason why we should be sending money to the Muslim Brotherhood, to Egypt, and there are many different alliances we have. Look, we're about
to... Well, the argument, though, for it, Colonel, is that we want to have a seat at the table. We want to have some influence there, that if we didn't provide this money, other nefarious forces would step in and take our place and take advantage. What do you say?
Neil, the nefarious sources have already stepped in. Look at the people that are providing weapons and armament to the Al-Qaeda-backed rebels in Syria, as opposed to Iran providing to Syria and then also to Hezbollah. You know, I don't want to sit at the table with someone that's going to poison me, and I certainly am not going to buy the food by which they're going to poison me.
Very good point. Colonel, always good seeing you, my friend. Thank you.
Thanks, now.
Alan West. Well, after